What is up, Sack Crew? You know what time it is. We are on another adventure, another little bit different than what we normally do. It is haunted, but unfortunately we can't get inside. We can't investigate yet. One day we're going to get in here.
We're working on it.
We're going to get in here. We're going to investigate. But we are at the... The Ridges at Ohio University in Athens, Ohio. So...
Otherwise known as the Athens Lunatic Society, or Athens Lunatic Asylum. Yeah.
Athens Lunatic Asylum.
That.
So we know that there's some haunted stuff going on in these buildings. Unfortunately, we can't get in. So we're just going to take you on a little bit of an adventure, and we're going to show you all around. The band's playing. They're excited. We're excited. There's people working out in the parking lot. They're excited. So let's go.
Students actually get to use this building. Some of it's broken down into administrative over here, and then back in the back there's a police station, so I can imagine they probably got some interesting stories to tell. Formerly known as the Athens Lunatic Asylum, this foreboding facility is known today as the Ridges. The doors opened in January of 1874 to treat mental illness and tuberculosis. At one time, the facility occupied over 1,000 acres and ran a somewhat sustainable operation, which included 78 buildings, livestock, and gardens. Both staff and patients cared for the animals in gardens, as this was believed to be a form of therapy on site. This beautiful Kirkbride facility had the traditional Victorian Gothic architecture and sprawling grounds that these hospitals were known for. If this style looks familiar, it's because Levi Schofield, the designer, also designed the Mansfield Reformatory, another historical and haunted Ohio location. Side note, if you're ever in the area for a little while, check out the Moonville Tunnel and the Lake Hope Furnace in the Zelaski Forest for more haunts nearby. If you love animals, stay at the Union Ridge Wildlife Center in Wilkesville, Ohio.
They're chilling, waiting. Band's playing again.
So they don't come and get us like everything else.
It's the one good thing about not being able to do an investigation here right now. We're not gonna get attacked, hopefully. Just so you know, I want everybody to know, this is the entire campus, right?
So this is all of Ohio University.
Yeah, so this is Ohio, all of it. But I don't want anybody to be confused. So this is where we are.
Looks like I'm not the only one that's drawn circles around it.
So we're at the Ridges. There's more of the school across the street. But
also haunted.
Ohio University is also haunted.
Very haunted.
Yeah, I know a few people that went here that have had some crazy stories. But just in case anybody was really wondering, I know it looks like there's a lot of buildings, but it looks like they're really small. People, that is not to scale. That is not what the buildings look like. They're not that small. Don't be crazy. Don't be commenting on here being like, oh, you can't fit anybody in there. It's an ant school. No. Not to scale. Not an ant school. Deal with it. And it's haunted.
Which is amazing. One of the first patients admitted to the asylum was a 14-year-old girl. She had epilepsy, but her parents thought she was possessed, so they took her to be locked away. Mental health care was much different back then, and people were admitted for various reasons, such as menopause, asthma, laziness, and as mentioned before, epilepsy. Many patients were subjected to electroshock therapy, lobotomies, restraints, and psychotropic drugs.
Trying to use the gimbal and it switched around to her.
No, using the gimbal. And for some reason, it just turned around to face me. So I guess it just wanted me to say hi. So hi.
it's a tunnel, but it goes up. Oh no, it does go down.
It's kind of cool.
So this might be the start of the tunnel.
Right underneath the building. Nice.
Many who were admitted did not have a mental illness. They were just dropped off to be forgotten. The note, "I was never crazy," was found carved into the woodwork. With all of the history and heartbreak behind these walls, it's no surprise that there are several ghost stories. With tragedies and sadness such as this, there are bound to be some who have never left. Some of the reports include shadow figures darting from room to room, disembodied voices, ghostly figures peeking out of the windows, laughter, and even screams. Loud crashes echo through the hall with no apparent cause. A woman named Mary has been known to have cordial conversations with trespassers. Explorers often did not feel alone. They would turn around quickly to see who was in pursuit. When they whirled around, only the darkness of night was there. Although these stories have swirled around for many years, most of the staff claim they have never had a ghostly encounter. When patients died, they would be buried on the grounds in one of the three cemeteries. Sadly, by the 1980s, maintenance of these cemeteries went by the wayside. They were quickly overgrown, and headstones were broken and vandalized. Many of them only had numbers on their headstones, sadly taking away the validity of their lives. By the years of 1943 to 2000, a few agencies stepped in. All of the information of the deceased was finally properly fixed. Everyone now had their name, birth, and death dates. After several name changes and a couple of cases of notoriety, the hospital closed its doors in 1993. The remaining patients were transferred to locations more appropriate to their conditions. One of the saddest and most notable stories is about a patient named Margaret Schilling. On December 1st, Margaret disappeared. She was found in an abandoned part of the facility that was no longer used. She had removed her clothing, folding them neatly by her side. Then she laid on her back against the cold concrete floor. She folded her arms across her chest and passed away. Due to the length of time and possibly the sun beating in, Margaret's body left a stain forever embedded onto the concrete floor. Margaret serves as a reminder of the care received at these facilities. It's important to remember that she, along with the others who walked through these doors but never left, were people. They were mothers, fathers, sisters, and brothers, and many others who deserved much more than they received. It truly is a sad story for many. Today, the campus is peaceful and scenic. Beautiful walking trails wind through the woods. You can even play putt-putt. Some open up to the beautiful clearings. One comes up to a mossy green pond with cattails waving lazily in the wind. Across a patch of grass, you can see one of the cemeteries. Looking around, one would have no idea of the harsh sadness that once prevailed here. It's important to remember history so it doesn't repeat itself.
One of the grave sites on the campus at Ohio University, over by the ridges.
Although you cannot go into the vacant buildings, you can visit the Kennedy Museum of Art or take one of their historical outdoor tours. Link is in the description below.
1855 to 1911, reunited with family 2011.
Thank you for watching, and if you love haunted, obscure, and quirky locations, be sure to subscribe.